Over 31 million doses of COVID-19 vaccines wasted. The Philippine Health Department says that's 12.5% of the 250 million doses that have been delivered so far to the country. But health officer in charge, Maria Rosario Vergere, says vaccine wastage is not unique to the Philippines.
Everybody has this kind of wastage sa country nila. Because nung nag-uumpisa po yung pagpapurchase ng bakuna sa bawat country sa bansa noong 2021 or 2020 na negotiate na may shortage. So everybody tried to forecast and buy as much as they could. So marami pong nagkaroon ng maraming doses within their buffers or sa storage nila.
Vergere also notes, while vaccine wastage may be attributed to its short lifespan, the public's vaccine hesitancy and complacency are also key factors.
Unfortunately, hindi lang po Pilipinas ang nagkakaroon ngayon ng experience of hesitancy, that experience of complacency, that experience of confidence among their people. Kasi ngayon po, all over the world, people are trying to move on already. They would want that they will go back to their normal lives at marami ang hesitant na tumanggap pa further ng bakuna.
The Philippine Health Department will launch another national vaccination drive targeting the pediatric population. Dubbed Bakunang Bayan 2, it will run from December 5 to 7. DOH data show only 20.8 million Filipinos have received a booster dose compared to the 73.6 million that completed the primary series. In July, the government launched the Pinas Lakas vaccination campaign to inoculate at least 50% of the eligible population with a booster dose. The target was adjusted to just 30% before the campaign ended on October 8. With a slight uptick in cases last week, the DOH is hopeful more people will decide to get vaccinated or boosted. The Budget Department confirms receiving an additional funding request from the Health Department for the unpaid benefits of health workers. But the agency says the DOH has yet to complete the submission of requirements needed for the processing of their request. The DOH has asked for an additional 27 billion pesos to settle the unpaid allowances of health workers, covering the period of July 2021 until December this year. The DBM maintains it has released a total of 19.4 billion pesos to the DOH to cover the allowances of eligible beneficiaries until June 30. It also notes that as of October 30, the DOH still has unobligated funds amounting to 113 billion pesos. The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has agreed to pay the wages of some 10,000 displaced overseas Filipino workers. That agreement reached a few days ago ahead of the bilateral meeting between Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman on the sidelines of APEC Leaders Summit in Bangkok, Thailand. The Saudi government has allotted a total of 2 billion rials to settle the unpaid salaries of workers from companies that declared bankruptcy in 2015 and 2016. Marcos describes the announcement as very good news.
Napakagandang balita talaga at pinagandaan talaga tayo ni Crown Prince. Sabi niya yung decision na yan ay nangyari lamang nung nakarang ilang araw at dahil nga magkikita kami. Sabi niya, ito yung regalo para sa inyo.
Marcos also says Saudi officials have assured them the failure of employers to pay OFWs will never happen again.
Lahat ng mga pupunta sa Saudi Arabia ay magkakaroon na ng insurance. Sila mismo magbibigay ng insurance kung sakali man mangyari ulit yan na malugi yung korporasyon na tinatrabaho kanila at hindi nila makuha kanilang sa yung insurance ang nakapayan.